Thank you for the grace. Thank you for the opportunity. Father, thank you for the privilege that you have given unto us to be in your presence at this particular moment. Baba, we return all glory, all adoration unto you in the mighty name of Jesus. Come and just lift your hands and just worship God this moment. Just tell him thank you. Just worship him for who he is. Lift up his holy name. He is the lifter up of our head. He is the marvelous God. He is the one who is, who was, and he is to come. And he has called us to himself. And this moment he has brought us together. Father, we say thank you. Thank you, Almighty God. In Jesus' almighty name we have worshipped. Amen. And so, Father, we have come before you in humility of hearts. Father, because we are nothing without you. You alone is worthy. You alone, Father, Lord Jesus, is marvelous. You are the lifter up of our head. You are the glorious Father. Father, Lord Jesus, before you we have come tonight. Come teach us by yourself. Father, come and honor yourself in our midst this moment. Come and do what only you can do in our midst. Baba, we cannot do anything. We cannot teach your people. But you alone, come teach me, use me, hide me behind your cross. And come take the glory, come take the honor, and let the blessings be ours. For in Jesus' almighty name, we have prayed. Amen. You're welcome to Digging Deep. We've been running some series, and this month is our month of breaking forth. And I trust God that if you can just trust his love, you're breaking forth in the mighty name of Jesus. Nothing will stop you from breaking forth, because not because you can, but because Jesus loves you. The topic for tonight is breaking forth through God's love. Breaking forth through God's love. Meaning, I cannot break forth on my own. You cannot do it by yourself. You can only do it because God is available. Because God loves you. Because God has a covenant with you. And that is why you're called to break forth. In this season, none of us will be limited in the mighty name of Jesus. Because the love of God is available to each and every one of us. And therefore, if we can just trust this love, we will break forth. You and I are breaking forth in the mighty name of Jesus. Our text is taken from this popular verse, John 3:16. That says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life." Shall not perish, but have everlasting life. 17 says, "For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved." So you are saved means you have broken forth already. If you know you are one of those people that have been saved because you have had faith and trusted the gift of God to humanity, then you have acquired the grace, the power, and everything you need to break forth. You and I will break forth in the mighty name of Jesus. What does it mean to break forth? What does breaking forth mean? It means to cross over, to break through protocols, to command attention to yourself, to do what others cannot do, to do exploits, to do great things within a particular period of time. That is what it means to break forth. And we're talking about God's love. We know God, our Creator, the one that is supreme, the Almighty. That is who God is. And what is love? When we look at, I looked up to see what love means. And I found some explanations of what love is. Love could be explained as wanting the best for someone, being generous, self-sacrificing, unending attraction towards another, and etc. It could also mean indication of acceptance, tolerance, celebration of one another. That is what love is. But let us look at love from the biblical perspective. And I take this from 1 Corinthians. From 1 Corinthians chapter 13. Verse 3 to 8. That is God's definition, the Bible's definition of what love is. Let's look at 1 Corinthians chapter 13 from verse 4. Charity suffereth not. Charity is love. And is kind. Charity envieth not. Charity vaunteth not itself. Is not puffed off. Doth not behave itself unseemingly. Seeketh not her own. Is not easily provoked. Thinketh no evil. Rejoices not in the iniquity, but rejoices in the truth. 7. Beareth all things, believeth all things, hopeth all things, endureth all things. 8. Charity never faileth, but whether there be prophecies, they shall fail. Whether there be tongues, they shall cease. Whether there be knowledge, it shall vanish. Only then, but charity, love, is all. And God has given us this love by sending His only begotten Son for you and I. From the Message Bible, it said, love never gives up. Love cares more for others than itself. Love doesn't want what it does not have. Love doesn't store, doesn't have a swollen head. Doesn't force itself on others. It isn't always me first. It doesn't fly off the handle. Doesn't keep scores of sin of others. Doesn't revel when others grovel. Takes pleasure in the flowering of truth. Puts up with anything. We're talking about love. Trust God always. Because that is love. Always looks for the best. Never looks back. Keeps going to the end. That is what love is. We just define what love is. John 3:16a says, this is how we know what love is. Jesus Christ laid down His life for us. He laid down His life for you and I. That is what God has called us to. He laid down His life because of how much He loves us. Why won't you trust this love? This is the foundation of your breaking forth. If you can only trust the love of God, if you can only accept this love, then you have started the foundation for your breaking forth. You and I are breaking forth in the mighty name of Jesus. Can you just believe this? Can you just trust God in this? If I trust God that He loves me, how will I break forth? How does it mean I can break forth? Because God's love is sacrificial, I can break forth. He doesn't love me because I'm worthy. He doesn't love you because you're worthy. Yet He gave His most, yes, we know He gave His most precious Son to save us from what? From the curse of the law. It is curse that keeps us down. It is limitation of laws that does not allow you to get to that place that you are going, that you're supposed to give. It is law that brings protocol that stagnates one. But if you can trust that law, it will allow you to break protocols because you're no more under the curse of the law. He therefore will not abandon you in your difficult times. No. He gave His Son while you and I were yet sinners. And because of that, He cannot abandon us. Because we didn't ask, He gave. Can you trust that love? Trust that love. Trust that love. Jeremiah 33:3 says, call on to me and I will answer you. And I will show you great and mighty things which you do not know because God knows you. That is why when you call upon Him, He will answer you. Call and you will break forth. Sometimes we just forget to call. And that is why our breaking forth doesn't come forth. Call, He will answer. Psalm 91 verse 15 says, He shall call upon me. That is God speaking. And I will answer Him. And I will be with Him in trouble. And I will deliver Him and honor Him. God is calling you and I to trust Him and call upon Him. Can you have that faith that says in this situation, God loves me, Ruth. Can I call upon him? We trust our brothers, we trust our fathers, we trust our uncles, who we believe are rich and can deliver us and can reach out to us. Why do you think those people will reach out to you? Because you believe they love you. Trust the love of God and reach out. Call out to him. He will make a way for you. In Jesus' name. Matthew chapter 7, verse 6 to 11. I will take the 11th verse because it's a popular scripture. Give not that which is unholy to the dogs. That is how the scripture started. They say you don't give the unholy to the dogs. You don't give them what they don't need, because they are dogs, they are lowly there. But God is telling you that when you knock, he will open. He says in verse 9, of what man is there of you, whom if his son asks bread, he will give him a stone? If we human beings know that when our children ask for bread, we do not give them stone, is it the God that sent his son to come and die for him, for you and I, that when we call him, he will not give us a way, he will not make a way for us? 10 says, or if he asks a fish, will he give him a serpent? Will you give your child a serpent? No, surely not. 11 says, if then being evil, know how to give good gifts unto your children, how much more shall your Father, which is in heaven, give good things to them that ask him? He will give good things because you have asked. Can you trust his love and ask him, because it is sacrificial? God's love is generous. It's not that he gives small, he's generous. He's abounding in love. When we try to define love, we find out that there are limitations. And one of them also in that definition says love is generous. God is generous. God is not limited by our weaknesses. He doesn't stop to reach out to us because you and I are weak. No. He that loveth not God, loveth not himself. God loves us because God is love. He loveth himself. But he didn't even love himself. He didn't take up away that love from us, but gave his son to come and die for us. 1 John chapter 4, verse 8 to 10. 1 John chapter 4, verse 8 to 10. He that loveth not, knoweth not God. For God is love. In this was manifested the love of God towards us, because that God sent his only begotten Son into the world, that we might live through him. Herein is love, not that we loved him, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the propitiation of our sins. He sent not because we loved him. Out of our lack of love, God sent Jesus Christ to come and die for you and I, instead taking on for us the sin that we have committed. Can you trust that love? Can you trust that because he died, God cannot come and make the sacrifice and not desire for you to have the best out of that? God will help us, that our faith will connect to him, to know that his love is generous above our sins. God's love is a commitment, it's a promise. He said, whosoever believeth in him shall not perish. It means that all those conditions that are making you feel as if you're perishing are not from God. God sent his son to redeem you from such situations. Those situations that are making you mourn, making you feel as if, I am done for it. My own has finished. The woman saying, I don't die. I don't finish. No, he came so that you and I will not perish. If he doesn't want you to perish, it means there is a way. Eternal life. What is eternal life? Better life for you and I. Fulfilled life for you and I. It's a peaceable life for you and I. It is a life that passes and lives above the trials of this world. You are in that place of peace no matter what happens, because you know that your identity is not of this earth. You are a citizen of a better place. And that is why it doesn't matter what circumstances are telling you. You have broken forth the day you gave your life to Christ. And when you renew that knowledge each day of your life, you rise above those circumstances. Not because you're worthy, but because God's love is a commitment that says He's lifting me up onto a better relationship. God's love is endless. It doesn't say that from here up to here is where my love is. Mm-mm, that's not what God is saying. God is saying through eternity, when you are a child, I loved you as much. When you are an adult, I still love you. In your old age, I still love you. That's the love of God, endless. It is not temporary, and it is not given to circumstance. Oh, when you were in Abuja, I loved you. Oh, when you are in the Niger Delta, in the creeks, and you are a militant, I don't love you. No, when you are part of the Boko Haram, when you are part of the terrorists, I don't love you. No, that's not the love of God. Love, God loves us in all circumstances. Even when we do those things that we feel it should be an abomination, and when we just repent, He opens His arms to us because He loves us. It is not temporal, it is a permanent love. Romans 8, 37 to 39. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through Him that loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. What can separate you from the love of God? What can separate me from the love of God? God is telling us today, nothing, absolutely nothing, can take you away, can take me away from that love, from Him loving me. Most of the time when we read these verses, we think of, oh, my trial will not take me away from God. But can you look at it the other way? God is saying that the fact that you are fallen, the fact that the situation is bad with you, the fact that you are not where you think you should be in your relationship with God, it doesn't matter what you have done. God is still saying, I love you with an everlasting love. It doesn't matter the depth of sin. It doesn't matter the depth of failure. It doesn't matter how many times you've gone down. Our God is saying, I love you. Just come back home and I'll give you a new beginning. Like I said, eternal life here on this side of creation is what? Living in peace. Getting all those things that make you content with life. Psalm 147 verse 5 says, great is our Lord and of great power. His understanding is infinite. So He understands your circumstance. Don't think that He doesn't know. God knows. He understands. And He still says, I love you. Trust that love. You are the only barrier to the manifestation of the love of God in your life. You are the only barrier, can only be the only barrier. If you don't reach out for that love, if you don't tap to the resources that love has given unto you and I, if you can only reach out to that love, connect with that love, receive that love, when a man asks a woman out, until she reaches out and opens herself, the relationship doesn't blossom. It's just the same thing with our relationship with Christ. A bride comes into the home and because she opens her heart to the man, she flourishes in the home. That is the same relationship. Can you accept God's love so that you can flourish? Accept that love and flourish. Then you will break forth on all sides. God's love to us is not because we deserve it. Remember, I said it is endless. So it doesn't limit by the circumstances of our life. It flourishes. We cannot ever do anything to deserve His unconditional love. There are situations where we see a woman being pursued by a man and we say, why can't she attend to me? The man is resilient. This is even part Human beings, we take that example and feel, eh? How come? God's love is beyond that. We run away. We go to the worst. We commit the worst crimes. We commit the worst of sin that we can ever think of. Even ourselves, sometimes we can't forgive ourselves for the sins that we commit. But God is telling us, I have loved you with an everlasting love. Can you reach out and connect with that love? He will not fail you if ye being evil. Matthew 7. If ye being evil, verse 11. If ye then being evil know how to give good gifts unto your children. God has no iota of evil in him. His love is unconditional. Just reach out. Romans 8, 5 verse 8. Romans 5 verse 8 to 10. And also we look at Colossians 1, 20 to 22. Let me take Colossians first, 1, 20 to 22. It says, and all having peace through the blood of his cross, by him to reconcile all things into himself by him. I say, whether they be things on earth or things in heaven. And you that were sometimes alienated and enemies in your mind by wicked works, yet now had he reconciled in the body of his flesh through death to present you holy and unblameable and unreprovable in his sight. This is the will of God, to present you without blemish, unreprovable. You won't be reproved to God. Can you reach out to that love so that you can break forth? Sometimes we feel that circumstances of life have dealt so badly with us that we forget about the love of God. We need the love of human beings to come and cure our heart. Can you reach out for the love of God? Romans 5:8 says, but God commanded his love towards us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. While we were yet sinners, we didn't have to repent for him to die. So in your sins, can you cry out to the Master? When you cry out to him, he will extend his hand and open your heart to the love that he offers. 10 says, Romans 5, 10, for if when we were enemies, we were reconciled by God, or reconciled to God, sorry, by the death of his son, much more being reconciled, we shall be saved by his life. While we were yet there, Jesus came and reconciled us. Have you taken that reconciliation? Have you received it? That gift, that while we were yet sinners, he showed his love towards us and made us heirs of the covenant that we wouldn't have been partakers of. This is the love that is calling you and I to break forth. Because in this love, you can flourish. In this love, stagnation is broken. In this love, limitations are broken. In this love, you can rise higher. In this love, he sends help. Because he loves you, he will send help at your time of need. Because he loves you, he will bind your wounds. Just call out to him. Jesus loves you and I. Do you realize that? Do you connect with that love? Are you ready to always reach out? Sometimes circumstances press us down and we feel, oh, where is God? Ah, God has rejected me. He never rejects any of us. He is too generous to reject you and I. He is too loving not to hear you when you cry. Can you speak to God this evening? Talk to God. And for the times that I have forgotten your love, Father, have mercy. Father, for the times I've forgotten, I have felt as if you don't love me. I have gone down and I felt I am alone. Father, have mercy. I know that you love me. Thank you for reminding me that you love me so much. You came to die for me. Thank you for your blood. Thank you for your body. Can you appreciate God? Just tell him. Take a moment and speak to God and tell him thank you for reaching out to you. I don't know, if you have not given your life to Christ, you cannot even pray this prayer. If you have not given your life to Christ, tell God this evening. Reach out and say, Lord Jesus, thank you for coming and dying for me. I now know that you have sacrificed yourself for me. Please come into my life. Be the Lord of my life. Be the master of my life. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' almighty name we have prayed. If you're one of those that have prayed that prayer, please reach out to any Bible Believing Church. We are from the RCCG Jesus Embassy. You can reach out to any Redeemed Christian Church of God and establish yourself. For those of us under the covenant, can we just tell God, help me never to forget your love. May circumstances of life never stop me from remembering your love. Thank you, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' almighty name we have prayed. Shall we pray? Father, thank you for this moment that you have given unto each and every one of us to be reminded that you love us beyond the circumstances that weigh us down, that you love us beyond the challenges of life. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Please help us never to forget. That is the foundation of our breaking forth. For in Jesus' almighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Amen.